Hello, my name is Jimmy Costello from the NX product marketing team, and today I'm going to be showing how using the quality dashboard can improve your experience when working on parts and assemblies where you are running multiple quality assurance tests on your product. We are beginning with a coffee machine, and I have already opened one of its sub-assemblies into a new window. From here, I have already opened an even smaller assembly with just the gearbox so we can take a deeper dive into running some tests on a smaller scale. With our subassembly now loaded, we can begin to set up our tests. I have already selected the tests we are going to run to save some time, but one setting that is important to note is found under the Run Options tab. In here, there is a checkbox for publishing the results to the quality dashboard. It is important that this box is checked if you want to review your data with this dashboard. Once this is selected, we can go ahead and execute our checkmate tests. When this is done, the first thing that happens is a new window populates in, presenting organized data from our tests. The quality dashboard is an excellent tool to assess how your checkmate tests performed, and additionally organize this data that is gathered into a palatable appearance. With the dashboard loaded, you can see it begins with a summary bar, which gives a breakdown of the parts tested, checkers ran, and the results of these checkers. This summary bar is a great tool to quickly gain an understanding the overall performance of your tests. From here, as we scroll, the next chart shows a bar graph of which parts logged successful tests compared with which ones logged errors in at least one test. As we continue to scroll down the dashboard, we next find a part summary table, which contains data for each individual part in the assembly we tested. One of the nice aspects of this table is that when we click on one of these parts, a new personalized report opens up specifically for that part, containing information regarding the part itself, attributes, as well as evaluated checkers. Continuing along our dashboard, the next section contains a bar graph for our checkers, as well as a table for the checkers data. This is yet another strong avenue for analyzing your tests for trends and patterns. Additionally, if we click on a checker, a new report will also populate in, containing more in-depth graphs and information for the particular scenario. Now that we've explored what information the quality dashboard presents up front, the next thing we will look at is how we can create charts and graphs of our own within the dashboard. To do this, we can go to the left side of the screen and select the circle with a plus called New Report. Here we can choose from customizable widgets ranging from pie charts to line graphs to images and text. To use these, you can simply drag and drop onto the screen and then personalize them by clicking the settings icon. This is a great tool for when the graphs in the overview summary report don't fully express the data you wish to capture or present. The last thing I want to look at is how we can solve the error message we had for one of our checkers. By clicking off of the quality dashboard and onto the assembly navigator, we can see a red X signaling where there was an early edge blend on one of our parts. To fix this, I'm going to open this part into a new window and delete the edge blend from the part navigator. When this is done, you can see our error message disappears. In conclusion, in this video, we have reviewed how to open up the quality dashboard and review the content found within the overview summary report. While doing that, we looked at the ability to view an individual part or checker for a more detailed approach to assessing our data. After this, we opened a new report and explored what creating our own charts and graphs would look like. And finally, we finished off by fixing our error message that we received on one of the parts checkers. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.